That's not the right one to start off with. Hang on. Boom! Nope, that's not the right one to start off with. Boom! That's the right one to start off with. Right, so good morning, driver. It is the annual gala at the Delllyn Heritage Museum. You will be driving the first train of the day, the popular demonstration freight train. Most of the train has been put together and sighted before, only requiring you to attach the brake band at the end of the train, which is currently in the good head shunt near the old level crossing. The Pass 101 DMU will be moved out of the way while you set up your train. Turn past any signals if required, and you will need to set all points yourself. So, apologies if that was a bit quiet, folks. Apologies for the late start. No, the microphone was just up. It was up here. So, it's TSL time. Stuff going wrong, of course there is. Right, so I need to push back to transport. I need to get in to the front of there. How am I going to do that? Hang on. Oh, to the couple, to the front. Okay, no, that does make sense. Right, let me get some sounds. Here we go. There's a DMU. Any estimate on what time the Pendolino will start? Well, this scenario is 45 minutes, so 45 minutes. That turns the noise down a little bit if we do that. Advanced version, I think it is. It's supposed to be the advanced version. It was the last time I used it. Let me just double check. So I can see the game. Oh, okay, now it's the advanced version. Set points. Come across, go in, and couple to that. Hockey for life. Do I have a Nebworth Trucking ATS truck skin? No, I don't. And I've been thinking about how I would get one of those. So, if you want to have a go at doing one, have a go. Fine Scotsman, Q1 is a good shout actually. Danimon, I don't know if this is a shunted scenario, I've not played it before. I don't think it is, but we'll see. Ouch. Let me ease that back a little bit. Right, now reverse back towards siding 2 so you can set the point brakes for the brake van. Oh, there's the brake van there, so I need to pull back into that siding, and then push back out and come and get the come and get that. So this is a workshop route, by the way, if you haven't already seen it. Oh, hang on a minute. I turned the follower off. Hold on. We were getting spammed by idiots the other night, so I had to turn the follower notification off. Arnold Ace Rimmer! Hey Matt, been off sick from work this week. On the plus side, TSL's been a highlight of your evenings. Keep up the good work. Really, really appreciate the donation, Arnold Ace Rimmer. Really, really do.
Sorry to hear you've been sick. Hope you're getting better now. Clear this junction. Missed your host of 14 viewers. Oh my word. I can't repeat that one, unfortunately. Thank you for the host. 14 viewers. Wow, Ruku. That's awesome. Right, let's switch these junctions here and go and get this. Press that forward. Well, it's good to hear if all is on the mend. Arnold Acer him up. We've got to get that brake van. Let's try not to turn it into matchsticks. Oh, here we go. People like, that's why I turned it off last time. Beat followers, stop doing it. No time, girl. No, I don't have anything. I don't have any kind of sound mods or anything on here. As is my normal standard, this is exactly and only what you get from standard Steam. The 87 you can get inside West Coast Mainline over Shap. There is also a separate 87, so the Intercity 87 is separate. The BR Blue one comes in over Shap. Guard sitting there going, get off. Oh, finally. Right, your train is ready. Set the headlights correctly. You will need to press H and then switch the forward reverse switch above your head on the right side in the cabin reverse. When you end up running with a loco forward, you will need to change switch back to forwards. You are due to make a short stop at Ferndale Farm to allow spectators to photograph your train platform. Where are we going now? Ferndale Ferry Dairy Farm Holt, which is all the way up there. Right, okay. So to do that, I need to change this switch. I need to come, actually I need to, ooh, this is going to be tight. I need to squeeze forward a bit so I can come out. So let's just squeeze a little forwards. I'll have a better look at this route in a minute. I think I've done this route before, but and the followers are gone again. And the brakes off, yeah, the brakes are off. SDKF said 250. Suggestions for good starting DLC to complement the first edition. Remind me what's in the first class edition, because I must admit, I can't remember. You're live streaming down the mineshaft. A nice one, Ronnet Gaming. I did this one with the 25. Yeah, so I did. So have a quick look. So we've got to go all the way up. I see, we're going up and then back. Yes, we're going up, running around and coming back by the looks of it. This should be interesting. Have I got past this junction yet? Right. Thank you. We need to set these headlights, don't we? Going to reverse. That's a good point actually, let me re-enable that, go back to the alert box, and just switch off follows. That's it. Yeah, good tip, Rubco. So the follows are back on, well, it's all back on except follows. Oh no, send the URL. Ah, that's just too hard to do right now. The alerts are back off and I will just watch it. But I'll look better, the K1 or the S160, that's tough. A little fast. Loving the whistle. Right, Gemmell, Midland Mainline, Riviera, and the Castle class. So, Gemmell, the class 90 is a good thing to hit. The class 321 goes well, I think, on the Gemmell. That one comes with first capital connect, so that won't fit. So yeah, the 90. The 150 pack is a bit hard to drive. 90 is okay, make sure you read the instructions. Midland Mainline. Oh, Midland Mainline, you'll want the Intercity 225, the class 91, because that doesn't come with it. So yeah, you'll want the class 91 to really finish off the Midland Mainline. I'm trying to think about Riviera Line. What does everyone think about Riviera Line? Oh no, Class 91's not on the Midland Line, is it, Nico? Class 91 is for the East Coast Main Line, sorry. What we do need to do is make sure that our path takes us via the right route. Which, Riviera, the first pass edition is Riviera in the 50s, isn't it? It's difficult because that comes with quite a lot of stock. Steven Jam, which Mardi route to get? So the original Mardi route comes with more varieties of the J94. The newer Mardi route, and obviously a slightly more track, the newer Mardi route comes with a better behaviour. So I much prefer driving the newer version of the J94. There's nothing wrong with the old one, to be honest. I'm going to have to take a look through the DLC catalogue and remind myself what goes on those routes. Because I must admit, I can't remember. Class 52, I think, comes with scenarios for a different route. I'm trying to think of the ones that come with scenarios for those routes. Around here to Ferndale Dairy Farm Halt. Yeah, 52 is Bonarios for modern Riviera, there you go. So it's the Riviera in the 50s that the 50s route comes with. Weird Al and Teasdale is a good shout, Cameron's Game, because it comes with quite a lot of different rolling stock. So it's another one which has got a nice variety. Limit coming up as to come in here. SDKF said 250. Send me a Twitch message, and what I'll do is I'll have a look around and I'll recommend you some stuff to run. Right, here we are. We're about to come and do the photography bit. Get your pictures. See you later, Cameron's Gaming. Right, now we continue to Lakeside. Going to shopping centre. Yeah, I'll bring the route map up in just a minute. This is the route map. So we start down here at Delllyn. Notice it's three L's, not two. So So we've got this area down here. You've got this Ferndale in the middle, and then up here you've got another set of sidings and so forth. Here. How are we doing? 20 limit. Good, it's going downhill. Captain Jenks, this is on Steam Workshop. This route is called the Delllyn Heritage Museum. Sorry, Ronit Gaming, I keep missing what you're saying. Flying Scotsman, yeah, that would be much better than just reading them out to me on Twitch chat where I'm going to lose them. Oops. Yes, pump cart would fit quite nicely on this one. How is everybody, by the way? Is everyone good? I noticed we've got quite a few people watching. If you're new, don't forget to press the follow button. And if you are not new, then awesome. Make sure you press the follow button, yeah? And don't forget, there's the YouTube channel. Go over there and press subscribe, watch the videos. There's over 1,000 videos on my YouTube channel. 1,000 videos! I mean, I'm insane. Yeah, I have to be. But yeah, I think there's over 1,100 videos now, actually. Malishtar, thank you for the follow. No, you're not supposed to refollow, Steven Jam. If you're an irregular and you haven't pressed follow, then make sure you press follow. It was addressed to the regulars that haven't pressed follow yet. Press follow. So the other thing is, so I've just had my latest rejection for being a Twitch partner. So, thank you. So what I want to do is, Ingagri Ben says he followed when you're not streaming, so no shout out. Well, thank you for the follow, Ingagri Ben, I really appreciate it. Or on maximum. Kind of a crazy person, am I? Joshy3 2003, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So yes, what I want to try and do is, if for those of you that are willing and interested and want to see this channel become a partner, Twitch partner, JJ Searle, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. What I'd like you all to do is to see whether or not you'd be able to make it to the channel as much as possible over the next month. Try and get the concurrent viewer numbers as high as possible. Spread the word about the channel to your friends on Facebook that you think might be interested. Don't spam them, obviously. Let's try and get as many people looking at the channel as possible over the next 4 weeks. In 2 weeks' time, I'll put in another request, and then we'll see what comes of it. So let's try a different way. This technique worked for Steven Jam. Not Stephen Jam, Steve Kiberton. They both start with Steve. And we'll see whether or not it gives us any luck. Obviously, it'd be really good if you carried on watching as well. That would be great. But I just want to see whether or not you would be interested in that little exercise to see whether or not we get anywhere with that. Right. How are we doing on the map? About to come into a 10, we need to stop at destination 1. I don't think we're set to go into destination 1. We're not. We need to come into the lair. Stop off and go to the headshot, so let's set that. And go into there. Right, we're all set now. Yeah, use your Facebook, Twitter, whatever social media networks you're on. Pass the word about the channel around. And, yeah, the more the merrier. Joshy Free, how does Twitch Space Train Sim work? I'll explain that to you once we get into doing Twitch Space Train Sim. And to be honest, you'll see. Then the mayhem begins. JJ Cell, remind me, have you seen a Twitch Space Train Sim yet? Or have you been spared the pain? The experience. Is it any difference to normal? So the idea, Joshy Free, is that the viewers drive the train. And I just sit back and watch, and chaos rules, basically. See you later, Ingegri Ben. Thanks for the follow. Good evening, Ben. Need the Battle of Nebworth in a 55. Ooh, that's not a bad idea. Right, uncouple the train and run into the head shunt before proceeding to Ferndale, where you'll pick up another freight train, which has received a lot of attention due to the fact that the dairy farm is allowing the railway to haul some cows. Hello? Doesn't sound like the right thing I should be allowed in charge of. You haven't seen it yet, no? I'm going to apologise in advance then, JJ Soul. Delllyn Bean, I have not put a bit of fuel into this train since I started. Not 1 ounce of anything has gone into this train since we started. But we're running it on. It starts quite ready to go, I think, is part of the problem. And I'm running it on a branch line, a little tiny brand preserve line, which means that I'm not using steam, really. Right, next we're going to go via Lakeside, back to the Ferndale Farm Halt. Oh, I see, this is where we're going to go to freight loading, is it? Yep, okay. Right, go via Lakeside. Lishtar, yes, this route is indeed on Steam Workshop. can't remember how to put water into this thing. Can't remember how to put water in. We've got water going in. Nope. You need the loo running. That on. So I don't know how to do this. I'm missing a lever somewhere, I think. What's the speed limit here? 20. Oh, am I using the wrong one? Okay. I was using the exhaust injector. I need to use the live injector. That's better. Just checked my Skype and I've got about four people yelling Mick at me from the beginning of the stream. Thanks, guys. Yeah, I know the principle GWI, I just hadn't remembered that I was using the exhaust injector. We're getting there slowly. I'm downhill now, I think. Initium, yes, you can certainly see the cab. Change that actually. Dilly Dorito, I think this is a modern era scenario. The Big Boy scenario is a modern one. Yes, he has transcoding. Amarillin has chocolate buttons and will not be sharing them. Everybody get Amarillin. Lenny, just been playing West Coast Main Line North. Is that now I get a rectangular box now to say when the station's called and the trains when they come near me? That's the F6, F7 overlays. Like that. That's F6 does that one. There's the 15. Oh, we're already doing 15. It's our instruction. Stop at Ferndale Farm Halt, just up there. Can you ask what got me into train simulators? Well, I've been into train simulators since about 2000. I started by, I got into Microsoft Train Simulator before it was launched. Then I actually was able to get a copy prior to its UK launch and just run a competition, nothing fancy. I used to run UK Train Sim, the main site for a train simulator in the UK, and my history with trains comes from my dad, but Train Simulator was really just a desire to do more with trains, but had no space at all, because at the time I was in a little three-bedroom house with Cameron at the time, so there was no opportunity for setting up a model railway. And Train Sim was a godsend, frankly. Right, reverse. Why so many workshop routes? I'm just trying to be a bit different, that's all. And I've had several requests to do more workshop routes, so... Moggy, yeah, mine didn't cost me anything. You know, being as it was a prize. Spam track, you don't need to make a model railway. What you need to do is follow my video on how to make a model railway in Train Sim, and then bring your dreams to life in the virtual world where they don't cost much. Trust me, making a model railway in real life is expensive! Hey, look, milk tankers! Bob would not be happy. That's made your naughty list. What naughty list, Moggy? Deadly Dorito, has your workshop route been... Have you suggested it? Drive back to Delhi, but go careful because you don't want to injure the cows. Remember, there's a lot of people watching this train. You'll have to wait at the signal at the end of the platform for the class 101 to make its journey to Lakeside. Due to the mechanics of the block signaling system of the line, be patient. It shouldn't be too long. Here he comes up. Yeah, JJ, one time when Bob was watching the stream, he went on about the milk tanks, so we did another scenario and I specifically swapped a load of wagons out and put milk tanks in instead. I was not popular. Yeah, do it again tomorrow, Deadly Dorito, and I will add it to the list to take a look at. Be careful with this freight, that milk is yours for cups of tea. Just get yourself some green tea and stop having milk in your tea. Coos! Did I showcase this route before? Yeah, I've done this route before. That 101 is slowly winding its way along the route. What's taking so long? Here's my Xbox controller. Woo! Who's wonky coos. Real cows on a train with Matt at the helm. Madam, please get back on the platform. Pity no tunnel, or you say you could go underneath. Oh dear, oh dear. Cattle class passenger, I know they're always complaining, aren't they? Oh, I hear something growling away over here. Got into train sims via a rather different manner. Went to Midland Railway Butley when you were young on for a winter event. You and your dad were still on the platform watching a Black 5 leave the station and got absolutely covered in soot. My mum wasn't impressed with either of us. Class. It's the Mince Beef and Milkshake Express. Sorry, the Mince Beef and Butter Express. Here he comes. Right then, let's put all this away. It's time to focus on what we're doing. I need to open the drains. Oh, hang on. I need to switch me junction. No. Come on, get out of the way. Get off me junction. They're off. Still locked. Monty, your mum got sprayed with oil by Gordon Highlander. Nice. BR Blue 101, you got that one for free. Depends which one you got, Stephen Jam. One of the BR 101 packs came with about 10 different liveries. just says be patient, wait for the block system, so it's probably got to go a bit further yet. Robert Lanny, F6 and F7 should turn them on and off. Like these. SF6 I'm just using to turn them on and off. You got the BR Blue, then the original Railways one was free. Okay. I must admit, I don't know how some of these things were packaged up. Kinky Apple, when did the stream start? It actually started just after 9:30. Late because of family stuff. King Apple, yes, this has been on since the start. It's only about 45 minutes. We nearly finished this one, actually. Your scanner is now white with a dark plastic underbody. So not pink then, Moggy. Why is it not pink? It needs to be pink. Pink is the only colour for a truck. See? Your train agrees with me. There you go. No, I think I have to wait for him to actually get past that signal. Does F6 give you the loco class or just the name? So F6 gives you sidings, and then F7 is supposed to give you the train service names, but I don't know why they're not showing up. But F6 has to be enabled, then F7 is enabled. Something like that. I don't quite know why. Mystic Modding, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Captain Jinx, your channel's almost set up, but one day next month to do a full day or two when you have a holiday. Nice! Oh, we're nearly there. Pull the brake off a little bit. Largely on the level, so I don't really need all the brake on. Pull the brake off, balance it up again, that's it. Ends. No, I can't change the point. There's no point tabbing the signal. I can't change the point in front of me because it's blocked. This service has still actually got that junction until it clears that signal. Because there are no signals on the route except for the ones at the ends, so all the junctions get locked up by AI. Like I said, Company Assume, there is no point spatting it. The junction is wrong. Train will derail. Nearly there. not going to just risk driving over the points and ruin a perfectly good scenario. Is there a way around that when creating the scenario? No, it's down to how the route has been signalled. If the route hasn't been signalled, then the proper, or the, not say properly, that's not necessarily fair, because this signal route's been signalled how they want it to be. But you have to run the route within the limitations of the signalling system. Or BT, sit and wait, just like real life, just be lucky it could be as bad as that surf liner. Yeah, that one, I seem to remember that just threw me off for no good reason. That was just very annoying. Try it occasionally, just in case. Is it glitched, John? No, it isn't. It's just because of the way the signalling system works, and because there are no signals along the route, effectively, until this AI train has locked all of this track until he clears that signal. So I can't change this junction until he goes past that signal. Then he's officially out of this block. Yeah, he's still in this block as far as the signalling system is concerned. Yards, IATA are, I think they work differently. And you'd normally put ground frame signals on, put ground signals on or hidden signals to sort of alleviate the stress. Right, now can we do it? Oh, we still can't do it. What? Maybe I don't understand this problem at all. Hey, we've got it now. Right. BNSF, do you know why DTG doesn't do any more in detail of making of videos? No idea, I'm afraid. Again, that's a question to ask Dovetail. Hey there, Stuff Nuggets. Lily Javito, I'd like to do some Rascal and Cottonwood, write some scenarios. If I don't find any workshop scenarios for locos, do I play official scenarios? Yeah, I can do. No, the problem with Rascal and Cottonwood is it only comes with these strange sort of free-roamy things with AI, which aren't really very clever. So I'd much rather run a standard scenario or a career scenario on that if someone can write one. But no one's written one yet. Got the A4 spam track, very nice. 1.28 miles, and we're just stopping at the runaround loop. All I need to do is make sure we actually parve there. Yep. Good night, John. Ben, I won't be able to chat tonight, but do send me a Twitch message. Almost there now, I think. Yep, almost done. Sorry, it's far too long, Copernicium. I don't think so. It hasn't even been an hour yet. It's about to have been an hour, but next time you want me to run a 90-minute scenario, I'll just reflect you to this. Should you go for the 56, the 58, or horseshoe curve? Not normally into American stuff, but clear crew interested you. Thought this was a 45 minute scenario. I guesstimated a 45 minute scenario based on looking at the instructions, but the actual nothing, there was no less than that, there's no time in the scenario. Even the time actually in the game says 0 minutes. The author hasn't actually set it up. So I guesstimated the time. Have I heard of the daylight? Yes, the daylight is in the game as well. TPTS is about 20-25 minutes. Southern Bellevue. Have I ever run the GS4 on the stream? Think so once. Oh, nice Hockey for Life. I'd be interested to see a look, take a look at that. We saw. You keep missing TPTS now. Key finishes with Winch work at 10 PM. Ah, oh, that's interesting to know. We saw. Of course, with me starting at 8 o'clock, I'm more than 2 hours into the stream by the time you get home. Right, well done. You've successfully hauled the Gala freight train and haven't hurt the cows. I haven't hurt the cows! For the win. Right. That was Delllyn Gala Freight. So that was the Delllyn Heritage Museum route as well, which is definitely worth a look. And that was the Delllyn Freight Gala scenario. Okay, let me get stuff set up. It's time for you to take over. Shudder.